Class, here's an array program that uses subcharts. You'll notice that we have a very simple modular design. We have two call symbols, each of which is going to call up a subchart. We're going to call up makeArray here to develop an array of 10 elements. The elements will actually be 10, 20, 30, etc., on up to 100. And then we're going to run a second subchart called squareArray, which will output the elements and their squares. Let's take a look at the makeArray subchart. And here it is. You can see that we've got a loop. Count, our loop control variable is set to 1. We're going to stop this loop when the count gets to 10. And since we're incrementing by 1 here, this is a loop that we know is going to run 10 times. What's going to happen 10 times? 10 times we're going to assign a value to the current element of the array by using the count variable inside the square brackets. What are we going to store in each element? We're going to store the count times 10. So in this way, we will develop an array, 10, 20, 30, etc., up to 100. Let's take a look at the square array. This array is similar. It also is going to run 10 times, as you can see by the condition here, count equals 10. That's going to stop the loop. What's going to happen 10 times? We're going to output the current value of the scores array, using again, once again, count inside square brackets, and then we're also going to output its square by multiplying it by itself. Let's see how it runs. There's the output. You get a table of squares. Using subcharts allows you to design your programs in a compact modular style. This is a desirable format.